Thank you. Amazing. I'm very much amazed with what has been happening in this assembly today. Everybody has talked about essential, urgent, extraordinary circumstances. All of you have talked about it. And here we are. Just see how we are here. You all talk about the difficulties you have had in convincing your people to do what you want them to do. And here we are gathered here. We are sitting from 10 a.m. up to now. 10 a.m. up to now, and we say it is extraordinarily important that we should not be what we are here now. We should not be like what we are here. You are convincing people. And Alcalo dispersed a naming ceremony in my presence. He dispersed people in a mosque in my presence. Health workers dispersed wedding ceremony in my presence. Here we are sitting down here. And we were the people who were telling those people, don't do this. And we are sitting very happily, like we are not concerned. Who tells me that we are not potential carriers of the virus? Tell me. Who tells me that? Who tells me that we are not going to be transferring this to each other here? There is no measure being taken here. You go around that staircase here, they should be cleaning, disinfecting everything there every morning. Nothing is happening. We all come, we go. And we say we are seemingly concerned about the gravity of the situation. Madam Speaker, Parliament are symbols and models. They should inspire others to emulate what they are by virtue of the fact that it's the supreme lawmaking institution of the country. If we fail to do that, we have a problem. When and how are we going to develop expertise in this assembly? How are we going to refine our processes and procedures in this parliament? This fantastic document on which people spent all their lives yesterday up to 3 a.m. and they came out with this fantastic document, we are not treating that. Our job is to review this. Whatever we say must be related to the merits and the demerits of this document. We should not have been here up to this time if we were doing that. And we all agree that this is a fantastic document, isn't it? It is. They have taken care of everything that we have been talking about here. You either agree with their recommendations and the positions that they have adopted. If you disagree, you say that. And you make a suggestion. That is what we are about. The fundamental reason why we refer issues to relevant committees is to help expertise to come out, to cut down on the time we take to deal with matters, particularly in the so-called special circumstances. We should not have been here. In fact, if I had not forgotten, I would have suggested we hold this in camera. This session should have been held in camera. Because of the seriousness of the situation that you have been talking about. And we should not have taken all this time to deal with a matter so simple and easy as to extend an extent of emergency. It's not difficult. But it is not just easy to jump to 90 days or 45 days. What is guiding you to jump into 90 days? What is there to justify 90 days? What is there to justify 45 days? It has not come out. Nothing has come out to convince me that we should go for 45 days. Are we prepared? No, we are not. And from there, up till now, no single material has been distributed in my constituency from the Ministry of Health. Not a single material has been distributed because there is nothing. They gave me 17 empty buckets, no other thing. Even the pump heads are not there. Up till now, Willy West, Willy East, I don't know the other place, but this is the situation there. And we are talking that we are saying, what is there? And this matter, before the declaration of the state of emergency, we were in it. From that time to the state of emergency, up to the end of the first phase of the state of emergency, government is still looking. They cannot see. You are laughing. This is not a laugh matter. They are still looking. Minister of Finance, they are looking. They cannot see. And I applaud all my colleagues, members of this assembly, who dip their hands into their pockets and bought materials to distribute in their constituencies to provide washing hand materials for their people. We did that. That's the only thing that has taken place in my constituency and in Willy East, up to now. And we are telling me 90 days. How prepared are we to sustain the weak and vulnerable for 90 days? How are we going to sustain them? You are asking people not to sell. You are asking transport quality to not to take the number of passengers they are usually taking. If they don't do that, what are you going to do? A shopkeeper who is closing his or her small shop where he or she gains her livelihood for 90 days, how is he or she going to survive? You are not telling me how that person is going to live. And yet you want to convince me to say yes, 90 days. And even 45 days, I don't agree with. 45 days, 1 month, 15 days, 1.5 months. Can you imagine a family person who struggles to make ends meet by selling this or that, and you ask that person to stop that, and you expect that person to be able to prevent himself or herself from this virus? What means does he or she have to do that? To eat is fundamental. One of the big cures to a sickness is to eat, to be able to have energy. If you can't food, if you can't provide food, how can you eat to strengthen yourself? I agree with everything in the document except one thing. And that is 45 days. That's the only thing I don't agree with. Because there is no basis for it. Tell me, the honorable member for Upper Salem said it. You have not convinced me that government has the means, because I have not been told anything. They talk about a fund. What is in the fund? How much is it there? How are you going to deal with that fund? What are you going to help the weak and the vulnerable? You have not told me anything like that. If you tell me that mathematically and convincingly, I will be able to determine whether that can be sustained for 45 days or for 30 days or 2 weeks or 3 weeks. That's the only yardstick I have. If you tell me that we have this sum of money and materials to be given to the weak and the vulnerable, those who have been prevented from doing certain things while they earn their livelihood, this is what we are going to give them in compensation, then I will be convinced to accept either 45 days or 100 days. This has exposed this country terribly. This virus has exposed our country terribly. It has exposed the disorganized nature of our country. If you were organized from Carton to Quina, you will have an inventory of all business persons, small or big. Small or big, you would have had an inventory of everybody here. When there is a crisis like this, you know what to do because you have everything here. We don't have that. We don't have that. How are we going to deal with the situation? Even if you have billions, how are you going to deal with the money? How are you going to distribute it? Who are you going to give it to? We must. The member for Serekunda said a lot of things which are fantastic. You have to do a lot of work to identify what is to be done in order for people not to do certain things. I must say with joy that the health team in URR, they are working very hard, very, very hard, day and night. The dead person who came from France, who died of the virus, who historically was a Gambian by origin, but because he was going to Senegal in France, he decided to take Senegalese documents. So when he came documentarily, he was a Senegalese. They wanted to come and bury him in Borokandakase, but the head team in Basse, the intelligence, told them, and they intercepted them at the border. They went back and buried him in Senegal, in Bantantinti. They are doing a fantastic job. They must be empowered. Those are the people who must be empowered, the frontline soldiers. Day and night they are working. I dealt with them on Sunday. It was like a Monday. Everybody was in office. But they cannot give what they are not giving. They gave me 17 buckets. And it should not be only two big buckets, but there should be a small bucket. You wash the water goes into the small bucket, otherwise it will be flowing. I went to Basse at the front of the trust bank. They had this washing thing, but there was no bucket. The water was flowing. That's terrible. So there are a lot of things that we have to do, madam. Honestly speaking, for me, I'm here today because of these exceptional circumstances of having to extend this state of emergency. But if it is done today,
Honourable Observation,
I will not come here on Monday.
Please, Honourable Observation.
I refuse to be observed.
Well, if, no. Honourable, let's allow him to say. What do you have a...
Yes, I want him to drink because tomorrow is very high.
No, sorry, please. Is it an observation?
I want him to drink because tomorrow is very high.
No. Then we will disallow it. Please, let's be serious. Go ahead.
You see, this man is joking.
Please, can we take this thing seriously?
Honestly, what I was expecting from the committee yesterday, they were all there, Minister of Justice, Minister of Finance, I think the Minister of Health was also there. I didn't see you in the list, but I think you are supposed to be there. Something happened, maybe you were not there. But I was expecting a comprehensive assessment of what had gone from before the declaration of the state of emergency to the declaration of the state of emergency, what has happened in terms of implementation of the recommendations that you made to be taken, in terms of what the health ministry and health workers are doing, in terms of what financially, because I'm sure I will say this in the presence of both of you here, the Ministry of Health is not adequately sourced. Because if you give me 17 buckets, my constituency has 46 villages. What am I going to do with it? I was attacked there. Because what I bought out of my pocket could not cover all the villages. One of them came and said, I've heard about you. Why didn't you come to us? Are we not part of your constituency? So you give me 17, full stop. The rest, what is going to happen? These people are creating problems for we MPs. That is creating problems for us. If you cannot cover all the villages, please stop it. It's better because it gives me a bad name. And I don't have money to provide for everybody. I do what I can, but I don't have the means to do exactly what is supposed to be done to cover the whole constituency. So these are the things that show whether we are prepared or not. Up till now, we cannot even provide hand washing material for our people, and then we are paying 90 days. How many months We have been in this terrible thing. We cannot still provide hand washing devices for our people. And yet you want it to be extended for 90 days. On what basis? That is the you have not convinced me. And 45 days too is too much. It's the same. Because an ordinary person cannot withstand the odds of 45 days. So we have to think this matter very seriously. And we have to change completely our behavior. In the face of this terrible virus that we are all talking about, we must change. Because, touch wood, it has not come here like Italy. That is why we are behaving like what we are behaving. But it is here, because it has killed people. It is here. There is no doubt about it that it is here. So we have to take measures. We should not be complacent. We members of parliament, we should not be complacent. Let us go back to our people and help organize them to prevent themselves from this terrible thing. There is nothing extraordinarily important in the order paper to warrant this parliament to continue sitting. In fact, I will make a motion that this particular session remains open throughout the critical period of coronavirus, COVID-19. The parliament should remain open throughout the critical period of COVID-19. It makes things easier for us. When there is a crisis, we can come and do whatever we are until we go away. If you close it now, you have to come back and reopen it again. That is my position. I propose that this parliament remains open throughout the critical period of COVID-19 to make it possible for us to come at any time according to section 34, subsection 5A. We can do that. That is my position. If anybody wants to second it, please do so when I sit down.
Are you asking for a second, or is it for the chair to ask for a second?
No. I'm not thinking. No, but seriously, the ministers here must bring something more convincing than what you have presented to us so far. Because it is even the 7 days that have lapsed, people who have lived terrible situations. It is not easy to make to survive by business in this country is the most difficult thing. There are too many business passes. Everybody is a seller. So who is going to be a buyer? That is one of the problems in our country. So we must take all these fundamental things into account when we are talking about how to address this situation. And the situation is grave. We must address it as such. Not the way we have spent the day here today, but differently. The Ministry of Finance must tell this August Assembly, how much money do you have in that fund that you have created? How much of it has been spent so far? And how was it spent? And what is there? What are you planning? How to spend it? How are you planning to spend it? How are you planning to help the weak and the vulnerable? When I say the vulnerable, you know what I'm referring to. The weak, you know what I'm referring to. The small business persons and workers who have been asked not to go to work because of the situation, how are they living with their families? I always ask myself, people earning less than $1,000 in this country, having a wife and children, and you are going to school, and you say there are people who are living in this republic, this country that we have fought so hard to have free from colonization, and we still are colonized in one way or the other. We are not free. People who do not have their lively means in their hands, controlled by themselves, they are not free. And that is what we are supposed to do here as members of the world. That is our responsibility. Our people must be helped to be free once and for all. That is our road. Anybody who cannot solve that, please resign and go. That is what we are about here. Can you imagine, since the declaration or the emergence of this virus, this country is still not prepared to handle it adequately. We are still not prepared. I am saying it. You are here, Minister of Finance, Minister of Justice, Minister of, I don't know, the other one is. Interior. Trade. Well, all of you are here. So, it is, the group is fine. Trade, you have a big load. Finance, you have a big load. You have a big load, but you are carrying, all of you are carrying it. But you still need more effort to be put into what you are doing. Because, as far as I'm concerned, all the days I have spent in the provinces, I have not seen anything being distributed to anybody. The health centers are as impoverished as they have always been. Because even a hand-washing device was not at your mouth. So please, I agree that there is a need to extend the state of emergency, but for how long will be determined by our preparedness. You alone can tell us how much prepared we are to handle the situation for 10 days, 20 days, 21 days, 45 days, 90 days out of the question. Madam Chancellor.